Cynthia, Cynthia, I always thought what a horrible thing it is to live without a heart, and now I'll get one from the Wizard of Oz. I must have been a silly sort of Josh when I went and spliced Matilda Jane. I thought I would find something that would be prime, but I realized I was insane. The fact is that she was too fond of me, and on my own she wouldn't let me stray. And if I was to go into a pub, all my pals would look at me and say, why must you bring your missus with you? Can't you go out on your own? Why must you have a keeper? Aren't you old enough to be alone? Why don't you go outside and lose her? If there's beer that needs mopping, then you can mop it up all by yourself. You can mop it up all by yourself. Can't you mop it up all by yourself?
That was charming. Thank you for obliging us. You were marvelous, Anna. And I think it shows why Montgomery and Stone was such a popular team.
My husband just thinks the world of you two, and you know what he told me? He's going to dedicate his next book, a sequel of the Oz story, to both of you.
Gracious!
What an honor!
Now, Maude, went and spoiled the surprise. I wanted these boys to see it when it came out.
So there's going to be a sequel to The Wizard of Oz?
Oh, indeed. It's a bit different from the first book. This one will primarily feature the characters of the Scarecrow and the Tin Man. As they've proven so popular with audiences, so in this book, the Scarecrow starts out as the King of the Emerald City.
Oh, I never realized I was in the presence of such royalty. Oh, please be kind to me, Your Royal Highness.
Just remember to bow every now and then, and you'll be fine.
The main reason I'm writing this new book is because you two fellows and Anna have made the wizard such a hit.
Well, I'm sorry I spoiled the surprise, but I really thought you two boys ought to know.
Thanks, Mrs. Baum.
We appreciate it. And when the book comes out, Mr. Baum, I am sure and I guarantee that we will be duly surprised.
Now, Mrs. Stone here was telling us how the Scarecrow is limber and gangly. Your Tin Man character, Mr. Montgomery, is of a different matter.
Yes, he's all joints and stiffness.
That must make it rather difficult for you to do your song and dances at times.
Well, not really. It adds other dimensions to our performance. It provides two of us with an interesting contrast, and we use it in our routines.
And we have a lot of them in this show. We have a football number and a sailor number.
Since our theme this weekend is a nautical theme, celebrating several of those Oz books and Oz-related stories that deal with life on the seas or rivers and around the land of Oz, how about if you give us a taste of that sailor number?
You mean Hooray for Baffin's Bay?
That's the one.
Oh, that's one of my favorites.
Oh, mine too.
How about it, boys? Will you honor us with that?
Of course. I'm game. Let's do it.